subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
This is continuation of video of Bra Foundation with Drop In Foundation. In part 1, we discussed about modeling and analyzing. In part 2, we discussed about reinforcement design of drop using strip method. In this part 3, we will look into design reinforcement of Bra Foundation using FEM, finite element method. I will drop link of previous parts, part 1 and part 2, connecting to this video in description with some other video links. First, go to Run and click on Run Analysis and Design. After designing, go to Display and click on Show Slab Design. Check on Impose Minimum Reinforcing so that if no reinforcement need in any area of foundation, design will show minimum reinforcement required according to code. Select finite element based in design basis. Choose direction 1 bottom rebar, that is X direction bottom reinforcement. Choose typical uniform reinforcing specified below in show rebar above specified value. Let's say we are using number 5 at 5 in center to center bottom reinforcement. Click on apply. This is contour color diagram showing extra bottom reinforcement of X direction needed after number 5 at 5 in center to center reinforcement. Since all extra reinforcement coming in location of drop foundation of draft which we already designed using strip method, so no extra reinforcement required after placement of number 5 at 5 in center to center reinforcement. Now choose direction 2 bottom rebar, that is Y direction bottom reinforcement. Click on apply. This is contour color diagram showing extra bottom reinforcement of Y direction needed after number 5 at 5 in center to center reinforcement. Same result as we get for X direction reinforcement, no need of extra reinforcement after number 5 at 5 in center to center. Now choose direction 1 top rebar, that is X direction top reinforcement. Let's say we are placing number 5 at 5 in center to center top reinforcement. Click on apply. This is contour color diagram showing extra top reinforcement of X direction needed after number 5 at 5 in center to center reinforcement. Look at this point, we need 0.23 inch square per foot, or you can say 0.3 inch square per foot extra reinforcement required in top X reinforcement. Calculation of this extra reinforcement is reinforcement required equals to 0.3 inch square per foot. We are using number 5 bar. Area of number 5 bar is equal to 0.306 inch square. Spacing will be equals to 12 divided by reinforcement required, that is 0.3 inches square per foot divided by area of rebar, that is 0.306 inches square. We get the value 12.24 inches. So we will provide number 5 at 10 inch center to center at location of extra rebar intensity contour diagram. Because main reinforcement is on 5 inch center to center, so this extra reinforcement will be placed in between two main reinforcement alternate. Now choose direction 2 top rebar, that is Y direction top reinforcement. Click on apply. This is contour color diagram showing extra top reinforcement of Y direction needed after number 5 at 5 in center to center reinforcement. Look at this, we need 0.24 inch square per foot, or you can say 0.3 inch square per foot extra reinforcement required in top Y reinforcement. Calculation of this extra reinforcement is reinforcement required equals to 0.3 inches square per foot. We are using number 5 rebar. The area of number 5 rebar equals to 0.306 inches square. So spacing will be equals to 12 divided by reinforcement required, that is 0.3 inches square per foot divided by area of rebar, that is 0.306 inches square equals to 12.24 inches. So we will provide number 5 at 10 in center to center at location of extra rebar intensity contour diagram. This is how we calculate extra reinforcement using finite element method. Hope you like my video, so like, share and comment below in comment section. Also subscribe and press bell icon so that you will never miss any update.